Right. So I'm going to be breaking down my song Chain Shot, which was part of that XL comp. I couldn't live stream it because my laptop's too rubbish to be able to live stream and for the project file to work properly. So this is just a pre-recorded video, so I can't answer chat questions, but hopefully I should be in the chat. If I'm not, then whatever, to answer questions. So I split the project into 8-bar sections. So I'll go through each section and then describe and explain the sounds in it, and I'll go through the sections one by one. So I'll play the first section here, which is the intro first. So, sounds in this section, I'll go through them one by one. This sound is just a sample from a pack somewhere, with a bit of processing on it. I'll just group these up so I can show you without the processing. Industrial, I just added some grain delay and some reverb and a bit of EQing, like this. Grain delay is really cool to give it some, to make it sparkle. And then another layer, which is the same sample but sped up a bit. Then, when I was listening to that, the sort of ringy sounds of buh, in the background, I quite like that, so I added a little sine wave layer to make that sort of come out a bit more. It's just a sine wave in Serum. Playing the notes, very simple. Then what else have we got? This thing, pretty simple. It's just two plain saw waves, no processing on it. And what I've done is I've put an LFO on the level and then modulated the rate of the LFO with a chaos thing, so it sounds kind of random and juttery. And I've just added a load of reverb and EQing. It kind of is, yeah. Then there's also this layer. It's from the same pack. It just adds a bit of ambience in the high end as well. Right, that's pretty much it for the first section, so I'll go into the second one. Ooh, sorry. So it's the same sounds as before, but obviously changing the notes. So I've just done that by going in and like transposing it with the Ableton, built-in Ableton transposition algorithms. Then I've also added this layer, which is like in the Serum, it's pretty simple. If I take the processing off, just a sine and then two detuned saws, one's like playing at a higher octave. And the processing here is just, I made it mono, added some noise in this sort of 9K range. To make it more aggressive, and then a bit of EQing. Oh no, saturator to sort of boost it. And had to EQ a bit because when you saturate like that, it always makes the low end around sort of 200, 150 hertz quite muddy. And also just taming in the high end a little bit as well. Then we've also got this layer, which is just a vocal chop. If I play it on its own, vocal chop playing in the noise filter, and it's just like repeating. And we've also got a saw wave and a flange filter on that, and this similar processing again, with a bit of dimension expander to make it a bit wider. And I've got this layer again. I think that's the same thing actually. Yeah, it's the same vocal chart, but just playing at a higher octave, and like it's actually got a bit of rhythm to it. Also, there's this layer, which I think is from Ellie Derp's pack sample panel, which is really good. I use that a lot. Just got loads of cool little sounds that you can layer in. Then I'll talk about the drums. The drums are really simple. This project's from, I think, March, maybe early April. So before I started making my own drums, these are all just samples. Just this kick, which is pretty basic. No processing on it really, but it does the job. And then that's playing this sort of pattern. I've got this little short sample for the sidechain to trigger it. And the sidechain is literally just, I guess there is no sidechain on that, but on the vocals there is. The sidechain is literally just a compressor, which has got the ratio at infinity, and it's just like got a really fast release. What else is there? The snare is just, what is this? I guess I must have made that somewhere. Or whatever. Cool little sound. And then this little thing, this little, again, a percussion sample from the Ellie Derp pack, sort of plays before the snare. Pretty sure this is the same sample, but just pitched up with reverb. Yeah, pitched up 7 with reverb on top of it. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Also, the vocals, I think these are from some grime song, I can't remember which one. Italy. The processing is pretty simple. Just got reduced ambience on there because the original sample had a bit of reverb on there, so I wanted to get rid of a bit of that. And just a bit of EQing and OTT to sort of bring out again, and dimension expander to make it a bit more interesting. Yeah, that's about it for that section. And then it just pretty much goes straight into the build-up. So it's the same again. Same samples again, pretty much, but obviously for the build-up we've got this, like, kick, you know, standard for most EDM songs. And a virtual riot clap. Yeah, not very much going on in the drums, in the ambient section. Couple of little downlifters, which is pretty simple. Just a detuned saw, and it's like, I think this is modulating the amp. Yeah. Giving it that wiggly feel. And then some white noise as well to sort of blend the sections. And then using that sample from the intro again. As a riser, and then this is a riser from somewhere. I'm not sure where. Pretty simple, just like white noise, pretty much. And yeah. Also the synths, like the main bass sounds, slowly being faded in. So I've got this EQ, which is just cutting off the high end. So you can see that slowly being faded in. And also got this reverb, which is slowly sort of fading out. So that's sort of just like making it sound like it's coming out of the sides and it's like coming into focus. Yeah, that's what that sounds like. Then we've got the pre-drop. Listen, you best keep walking, watch me again, won't see much talking. So there's this really loud vocal. Listen, you best keep walking, I think it's from a splice pack somewhere. I mean, if you want the vocal, then just screenshot that, type that in on splice. But yeah, just some OTT and dimension expander to make it sound really aggressive. Listen, you best keep walking. In your face. Then this sound, which I'll get into in the drop because that's sort of a sound from the drop, and then this little most of these sounds in this project are frozen because I'll have made them in different sound design sessions. That's just like some weird sort of scrapey metal sound I've made in Serum and frozen out. And that leads into the drop, so I'll play that. So I'll go through all the sound. In fact, I'll do the drums first. So the drums, you know, like, these are all just samples pretty much, because back then I didn't really know how to make my own drums. So I think I've got Neutron 3 elements because I'm using the transient shaper in it. But nowadays I just use Kilohertz transient shaper because that's really good. Just a bit of saturation, boosting the low end a bit. And then there's this click sound. Just layered on top. And then for the clap, this is just some an ominous snare, which I must have got from somewhere. I don't have his pack, but I think someone like sent this individual sample in a group somewhere, and it sounded pretty cool. So it's just faded out to layer in with the kick. In terms of percussion, there's just these little crashes. On the cymbals, we've got some processing. There's just a dry rack pretty much, and then this other rack, which has like got some OTT and like Hass effect sort of thing to make it more stereo and shit. And some more EQing. Just bring them out a bit more. Same with this one, I think. Right, I'll get onto this synth then. So pretty much all these sounds are just like weird sort of blips that I've made in Serum, but like shit like that's really easy to make. It's just like FM and filtering. Processing I've got on it, yeah, so there's this thing, I don't know what that's doing, no, that's not fair, must have got duplicated, it's a rhythm shifter, which is like, a thing that sort of, I'm not sure if this is true, but I found out about it from like Virtual Riot's live streams back in the day, where you basically split the low end and the high end and like only frequency shift the high end. Even though it's not really necessary because there is no high end in this. No, any, there is no low end in that sample. So it's just being OTT'd and EQ'd. And then I've got this sort of reverb rack thing, which is like, pretty wet reverb and then some EQing to sort of sort it out, and then sort of bringing it back up with multiband compression and like glue compression, because obviously if you turn it up that high, it's going to make it pretty quiet. So without the processing, it just sounds like this. Really simple. Right. This next sound. Pretty much the same thing again. Rhythm shifter, OTT, EQ, and the reverb rack. I've used this reverb quite a lot because what I like to do is sort of when I'm making a song or a track, I'll make a bunch of like sounds and effect racks, and then I'll use them throughout the song to sort of make it cohere, make the song cohere better. This is sort of, I think this is the same sound even, yeah, but it's just like pitched up by 6. This adds another layer. This is same processing again even. This is a different sort of sound, like some metallic thing that I've made in Serum, and I've fucked around with the warping, like I pitched it up a bit, so the original sound sounded like this. And then with the processing, is that metallic thing. This is literally like, I made a song way before this one called Can't Allow Them. And what I did to sort of add thickness to it is just took the basses, like the bass stems from that song, and like resampled them into this song. Because obviously all the basses are going to sound pretty thick because they've been mastered and like mixed together in that song. So adding this as a layer just like makes it sound richer, basically. Even though this is pretty much just like noise, adds a bit of mids and stuff. It's just got the rhythm shifter thing and EQing and the reverb rack thing. I think it's pretty much, yeah, just been warped a little bit, like with the tempo. This layer, okay, I'll talk about the sub, because that sort of comes from the sub. The sub is pretty simple. I think it's just a sine wave in Serum with all this processing on it. Yeah, something like that, yeah, it's just a sine wave. And then, it's got utility to make it mono, even though it already will be mono. And then, erosion to sort of add some noise. I'll go through them one by one. Erosion to add some noise, and then this saturator, which is like just slamming it at 13 decibels with this soft blip. And then after you do that, just had to clean it up a bit, because when you saturate, obviously it gets really muddy in this sort of region. And then I don't know what this is. Yeah, that's it pretty much. And then just an EQ to turn down the highs a bit. I'm just playing sort of a really simple riff sort of thing. And then what I did was I took the sub and I was sort of making the basses and then duplicated it and put it in with the synths. And instead of playing the sub note, I put all the notes down an octave and cut away the low end. So you'll just get sort of the vibrating noise that you get when you sort of put noise and then saturate it when you get a sub. So that adds a nice sort of crunchy layer. This sound, this sort of ping sound, is from that song again, Can't Allow Them. Just with that reverb rack on it, really making it stand out. It's just like a click sort of ping sound, which has been, well, it's been pitched up. So that's the original sound from the song. Pretty simple. Pitched up loads to make it really ringy, and then just lots of reverb. And it still sounds pretty harsh, to be fair, but you, like in the context of the mix, you can't, it doesn't really matter. So this is just like taking away a bit of the harshness, but it's still a bit harsh to give it character. And then this is just another final layer. I think that's just like it's the same sound as here, but without the processing on. So I don't know, adds a bit more tone. Oh yeah, this sort of fill thing. So pretty much all it is the sub playing this sort of melody, and then this sort of vocal chop, which is just like a from a Kara pack, and I've just like transposed the sample to get the notes I want. Yeah, that's it. And it repeats. Then in this section I've got like the that metal scrapey sound again, and a little bit of the vocal. So then in this section, pretty much the same, except the sort of pattern's changed a bit. So I've just changed the drum pattern. And then copied and pasted the basses and the synth sort of samples and the sub to like match that rhythm. So this sound is just some, again, a sound from a pack somewhere. Pretty cool sounding, metallic G. And then this section. Same again, but all I've done basically is like taken the sounds in this section and then changed the pitches. So in the first section, this sound was at 8, I think, and then now it's at -6. So just like an easy way to change up the tonality of the sounds. Then there's a little pickup bit. So when it gets to sort of the switch up or the second drop, sort of whatever you want to call it, there's a little pickup bar. Listen, you best keep walking, work me out. With the vocal. And that pretty much takes us into the switch up. So I'll play that and then I'll go through all the sounds in that. So with this section, I don't really need to explain that again. It's pretty much the same as the first section. But this section, the drums are pretty much the same. There's a bit more percussion going on, like sort of. That's it really, though. Not much more. So I'll go through it. I'll go through the sounds one by one. So this sound. This sound at the start is a bunch of layers. You know, this is just like a really simple, again, I've used the reverb rack thing that I made, but this is a really simple pluck sort of thing made using FM. Then we've got this. Actually, these sounds are what make up the sort of gun sounds. So actually, I'll talk about that later. This, which sort of leads into the main riff, is just a Must-Die sample from his pack. Really good pack. Sounded like that, so I just thought it'd be cool if you picked it down. Don't know if that's cheating, but whatever. With just, yeah, frequency shift or whatever on it. Okay. So, I'll go through the sounds Most of the oomph of this sound comes from the sub. Pretty much the same sound as the one before, but it's playing this sort of rhythm, and it's like playing at a higher pitch using the pitch bend thing in Ableton. And also I've added these little like swoop downs to give it a bit more like impact on each of the hits. Pretty easy way to just like make things impact more, just add a little pitch down. So layered on top of that is these little sounds. So this sound, I'll go through them. Again, same processing as before, it's just a rhythm shifter and a reverb rack thing. In the serum, we've got a like basic shapes triangle being FM'd from a saw, but it's like the carrier signal is like higher pitch than the modulating thing, so it gives it that sort of vibratory feel. I can't really explain how FM works because that would take too long, but yeah, just FMing. And then we've got distortion and a reverb filter. The reverb filter is giving it most of the character, really. Sort of giving it that sort of pitch bend sort of feel. Then on top of that, we've got this. Just a little noise sort of pluck using the white noise in Serum. And then being frequency shifted up. This sound. So it's basically just like a little pluck sort of thing. Just a triangle, a high pitch with a band pass filter with like a high resonance sort of boosting the peak. And then again, distortion and reverb filter to give it character. On its own, it just sounds like that, but then with the reverb filter. Without this sort of reverb, though, it sounds pretty weak, but this reverb and like compression, they sound really big. Then this sound is just another layer similar to this one, with a slightly different tone. It's just being EQ'd a bit, so it's only the very highs. And together it sounds like this. And in the background, we've just got that same sort of click from the first drop. But it's just like descending down in pitch using transposition. Then in the background, we've got this, which is like a pretty simple little effect. Without the processing, it's just a lot of detune, got some FM going on. And then this sort of LFO is like rapidly modulating the volume and also the coarse pitch. And it's a bit of distortion. And this ring mod, thing using the frequency shifter sort of makes it sound a bit dirtier by adding in that sort of 25 hertz frequency. Then we've got this reverb rack, but also we've got this sort of Hass effect as well, making it sound really wide. And then just again cutting all the low end away, we've only got that sort of high pitched trickle. Then we've got this sound, which I think is from another project of mine. Yeah, it's just frozen sounds again from Serum, with a bunch of effects on them. I'll go through them one by one. Oh, shit. Yeah, really simple sound. Got a bit of overdrive, OTT, saturator, humidity again, and EQ. Sort of just making it more aggressive, and then a bit of vocoder to sort of tone it down a bit. Again, this rhythm shifter thing, pitching up by 500. Then I've used the erosion using the sine wave thing. Give it a sort of like, almost like, it's almost like a redux effect, like a bit pressure. And then a bit of OTT. And then EQ again, just take away all that like muddiness in the low end that all these effects have caused. And then that's pretty much it. And then at the end of this section, we've got like a little vocal from the same grime song as before, with some quite aggressive processing on it, just OTT. Usually when I put OTT on stuff, I like to boost up by around 8 or 10 decibels, because OTT usually can make sounds quieter sometimes. And then it's the same again. With like, again, what I've done is just gone into the, whenever there's samples, I've just gone into them and changed, like fucked around with the transposition to give a different tone. And then I think with this one, pretty much this sound is playing a different note, so it sounds a bit higher up. But yeah, also there's like this sort of jumble of notes, which sort of, yeah, rapid, just random notes sort of makes it sound cool. Also, what else is there? There's a gun sound in there, like just a gun, like sort of firing sample. Oh, there we go. I think this is it. Yeah. Just ripped from YouTube. Yeah. So that's pretty much it. And then the same again in this little section. So then at the end of the switch up, I just have that power vocal again. But this time it's got the echo thing on it, so it's sort of fading out into the sides. And then the same sounds from the intro fade back in. Oh, wait, what? Okay, I'm on the wrong drop. Still the same. Yeah. The intro sounds fade in again, and then we've got the vocal and all the sound. But this time, like, the notes for the vocal sound. Just different, just to change it up a tiny little bit. And then we're back into the build-up again. So the build-up's pretty much exactly the same as the first time around. Okay, so onto the last drop now. The drums are pretty much the same. Oh, yeah. Change the snare. So there's also, it's not just that ominous sort of clap. Also added this sort of plucky Simix one. Top. Give it a little bit more impact. So it starts off with like the same sounds in the first track, and then they sort of stop, and I've used the same synths that made that sort of sound to make this sort of gun sound. So they're just sort of playing a really simple rhythm. Yeah, this one's playing. Same as before, pretty much. Except this time we don't have that sort of shiny, plucky, colory sound from before, this one. Yeah, and the sub is just following that pattern as well. Then also layered on top of that is sort of the synth sounds, which are just layered onto the kick and the snare. This usually helps when you're like making a dubstep song, which has sort of a fast rhythm, like a gun sound. It can help to just add like, it doesn't have to be any specific sound, but just like any sounds on the kick and snare, which just like give it a bit more impact. Like these. So without them, we just sound like this. Basically, it stops it sounding so flat. And they've got the same background effects as before. And then changes up a bit, so we've just got that same idea from the first drop again, with a slightly different rhythm, which is being sort of carried by the drums and the synths are following that. And then in this like next section, pretty much the same again, but with a little fake out, so the drums cut out. Oh, also there's this little guitar sample. Sort of really aggressive, that's cool. So yeah, that's it pretty much. Then, yeah, I don't know if there's much more that needs to be said. You have the vocal sort of echoing out, and then the intro parts fade back in, and we have the outro. This is pretty much exactly the same as the intro, except in reverse, so we've got the bit with the drums here. Then the drums like come. I've just got those synths from the beginning again. And then just using reverb, think on the master? No, somewhere. Yeah, just to fade that out. So yeah, that's pretty much it in terms of structure. And then mixing, pretty simple. On the kick and snare, I've just got like a little compression just to stop them like clipping like loads. On the bass, see, on the synth sounds, I wouldn't do this nowadays because usually nowadays what I do is just pretty much process each track individually and have like no processing on the groups and no processing on the master to try and make it as simple as possible. Because when you put loads of processing on the like groups, it just gets complicated. But yeah, so I wouldn't advise doing that. But anyway, if you wanted to know, the processing on this, it's just cutting away the low end in the synths. And then OTT, saturator again. Then sidechain. And then these things are just for like fading in the sounds and the build-ups and shit. Ambience, there's nothing on there. And the sub, yeah, just on the sub, just sidechain. That's pretty much it. These things are just like parts I used for sound design. On the master, see, nowadays I wouldn't put anything on the master apart from a saturator with a soft clip off to tame like peaks, but yeah, this time I've got an EQ, which is boosting the highs a bit to make it more aggressive, and then some multiband compression just to sort it out a bit, to sort out the balance. And then this vintage finalizer thing, which I can't remember where I got it from, but it's like a effects rack with some compression and saturation. Pretty useful. You can dial in the like parameters and stuff. Then got an EQ to sort of cut out the stereo lows. Yeah, and then dock like at 100 hertz, dock some of that muddiness out. And then just a saturator with a soft clip off. Basically all that does is just tame peaks. I can show you without it on. Peaking at 8.6 with it on. Peaking at 2.8, which is like manageable. Even though it's still peaking, so it's not really cutting it off. It's not really removing any of the dynamics, but it's still making like the clipping more manageable. Anyway, I think that's it. Yeah. Goodbye. Thanks for watching. See ya.